Let's talk about how hackers can listen to your phone calls, and I'm going to break it all down so you can understand the process, step by step. First, we need to look at the technology that hackers can use to get access to your calls. One of the tools that can help with this is Wireshark. Wireshark is a powerful packet analysis tool that allows users to analyze network traffic in real time. It's an open source tool, which means it's freely available for anyone to download and use. It's a GUI-based tool, which makes it relatively user-friendly, but it also has a terminal-based version called T-Shark for those who prefer working with the command line. Wireshark helps hackers by capturing data packets that are sent over the network, and it can be used to decode and analyze these packets to get sensitive information, including phone call data. One important aspect of this process is Voice over Internet Protocol, or VoIP. VoIP allows phone calls to be made over the internet rather than through traditional telephone lines. If you've ever used apps like WhatsApp or Skype to make calls, you've used VoIP. The big advantage of VoIP is that it's often much cheaper, especially for international calls. But it also opens up a security vulnerability. The data that is transmitted during a VoIP call, which includes your voice, is broken down into small packets that can be intercepted. These packets are transmitted using internet protocols like SIP, Session Initiation Protocol, and RTP. SIP is responsible for setting up the call, while RTP handles the actual voice data during the call. These protocols are the key to understanding how hackers can intercept and listen to VoIP calls. Now, let's break down how VoIP works. When a call is made using VoIP, the SIP protocol kicks in first. The process starts with the caller sending an invite message to the recipient. The recipient then sends a 200 OK response to accept the call. Finally, the caller sends an ACK message, indicating that the call setup is complete. This is called a handshake. Once this handshake is complete, the RTP protocol takes over. RTP is responsible for transferring the voice data between the two parties. But here's where things get interesting for hackers. If they can capture these RTP packets, they can listen in on the conversation. Now, before we go any further, I've created a VoIP interception cheat sheet, breaking down all the methods I just talked about, and more, into bite-sized, actionable steps. It's packed with everything from setting up Wireshark filters to advanced packet analysis techniques, all things I can't share here because, well, YouTube will take down the video. Inside the Academy, you'll get access to hands-on walkthroughs of setups, practical hacking scenarios, and techniques used by top professionals in the field. And for the next 48 hours only, you can use the promo code HACKER30 to get 30% off your first month. That's just $13.99, less than a night out, for resources that could help you land a high-paying cybersecurity gig. Plus, by joining, you directly support this channel and help me make this my full-time job, so I can keep creating content like this and even better. First link in the description. Don't miss out. So, how exactly does a hacker capture these packets? That's where Wireshark comes in. To start capturing packets, a hacker needs to choose the correct network interface. In most cases, they will capture packets from a local area network, or LAN, where the device making the VoIP call is connected. Once the packets are being captured, they will see a lot of data flowing through the network. But not all of this data is relevant to the VoIP call, so they need to filter the packets to focus on the ones that matter. Now, let's talk about how to actually listen to the conversation. Once the hacker has captured the RTP packets, they can use Wireshark's built-in features to listen to the conversation. After applying the RTP filter, the hacker will see a stream of packets that represent the conversation. In Wireshark, they can go to the Telephony tab, then click on VoIP calls, and this will bring up a list of captured VoIP calls. From here, they can select the call they want to listen to and click on the Play Stream button. This opens up an RTP player that allows the hacker to listen to the conversation. The interesting thing here is how Wireshark colors the data. It uses blue and black colors to represent the direction of the call. Blue represents the packets coming from the hacker's system, while black represents the packets coming from the person on the other end of the call. This color coding makes it easier to follow the flow of the conversation and gives hackers the ability to analyze both sides of the call.
Testing 1, 2, 3.
Now, while this sounds technical, the bottom line is that if someone knows how to use Wireshark and other similar tools, they can intercept and listen to your VoIP calls. This is why it's so important to secure your VoIP communications. Hackers can use Wireshark to capture and analyze packets, and depending on the encryption methods used by the VoIP service, they may be able to listen in on calls with minimal effort. But there's a catch. Not all VoIP calls are vulnerable. Many modern VoIP services use encryption to secure the communication between the caller and the receiver. This means that even if a hacker captures the packets, they won't be able to easily decode the data and listen to the conversation. This is why using encrypted VoIP services like Signal or WhatsApp is important. Encryption adds a layer of security that makes it much harder for hackers to eavesdrop on your calls. In conclusion, while hackers have the tools and techniques to intercept and listen to your VoIP calls, the good news is that there are also ways to protect yourself. By using encrypted VoIP services and being mindful of your network security, you can minimize the risks of someone eavesdropping on your conversations. Wireshark is a powerful tool, but with the right precautions in place, it's not something you need to worry about.